kidding? I've been waiting half my life for this.
You read me, Frohickey? Frohickey, you there?
Man, oh man, if I wasn't working.
Forget the chicks, Frohickey. The king has left the throne.
Ladies and gentlemen, some holiday crew
showtime.
Proud to present the greatest rock and roll star of all time. Born into humble surroundings in Tupelo, Mississippi, his gyrating hips changed the course of music, and his thrilling voice made him known and loved the world over. He has sold over 1 billion records, making him the biggest selling solo artist in history.
Sorry, Mr. Presley.
50,000 fans can't be wrong. Ladies and gentlemen, the king himself, Mr. Elvis Presley!
Running his prints now.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog. Crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine.
Frohickey, what's going on?
I hate to tell you this, bud. Ain't no way this is the king.
How can you be sure?
You know, other people might have a reason to go on the lam as Elvis, other than the real Elvis.
Then who the hell is he?
Thomas Ames, wanted for wire fraud and embezzlement.
Jimmy.
Yeah, they said you was high class. Well, that's just a lie. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit. You ain't no friend of mine.
U.S. Marshals.
Hanger. Thank you very much.
Say, might not have turned out like we'd hoped, but the king would have been proud.
Take that stupid thing off.
I kind of like it.
You're rubbing my nose in defeat. Take it off.
Langley, we all thought we were onto something. On paper, this man Eames looks like the real Elvis.
Same birthday, same birthplace, same height and blood type.
It could have been him, hiding in plain sight, doing what he does best.
You know, call me crazy, but I'm starting to think that maybe Elvis is really dead.
Seriously, man. Take it off. Can I help you?
Melvin, it's Alberta Pfeiffer.
Do I know you?
It's just like I pictured it. And there's Richard Ringo. Though I wish you'd cut your hair. And you must be the new one, Jimmy. I love your smile. But, John, your words have stirred my soul. So principled, so strong.
You're one of our readers?
From the first issue 12 years ago. Haven't missed one since, which is why I've come to you.
As a last resort, believe me. Mrs. Pfeiffer's son, Douglas, is on death row in Texas, awaiting execution. I'm his attorney, Jeremy Wash.
He stands convicted of murder. He's not guilty. I know every mother says that about her outlaw son, but in this case, it's true.
And you want us to prove it?
I want you to talk to him, but that's asking a lot. Lately, Douglas refuses to talk to anyone, even me. I can't get in. The only person he'll have a visit with is Jeremy here.
We have several steps left in the appeals process, but Doug wants to streamline things. He won't say why, but he's pushing for an execution date. One could be set as early as next week.
18 months ago, he pleaded not guilty. He fought his conviction tooth and nail. And now he says he wants to die. And he won't explain it to anybody. There's some sort of conspiracy here. Some sort of, I don't know what. But John, if anybody can figure it out, it's you four.
What are we gonna do?
Well, not a whole hell of a lot.
What?
Hey, we can hack into the police record, we can read the trial transcripts, but we're not talking to Mr. Pfeiffer. He doesn't want to talk to us.
But guys, his mom, come on.
Jimmy, I'm not confident you're aware of this, but you can't just walk into a penitentiary.
The A-team did.
Oh, God, here we go.
The A-team snuck into this prison, dressed up like inmates, and then busted the guy out who was wrongfully accused. I mean, yeah, I know it's a TV show and all, but the theory is sound.
Jimmy, every half-baked TV series that runs out of ideas in the fourth or fifth season does their sneak into prison dressed as an inmate show. And what does that have to do with what we're talking about here?
Not one of us would last 10 seconds inside a prison.
Jefferson said, better 100 guilty men go free than one innocent man be condemned.
The Jeffersons. I think they did it on that show, too.
I think maybe we could do it. I think it's worth a try. We defend the defenseless. I don't see any other way. You ready for this?
Are you?
We're running out of time. Can you get him in or not?
I can get him in. Ask me if I can get him out.
Where'd you all come from?
Wesley and Dillinger.
Well, Dillinger, you got the right name for where you're going.
Sergeant Runzelhoff, you are on G-Wing ADSEG, Administrative Segregation. Here you will spend your first 6 months. This is your inmate orientation handbook. Do not lose it. Do not trade it. Read it cover to cover. It spells out all the rules. Follow the rules and there will be privileges. Break the rules and I promise you, it only gets worse from here.
Step back. Lock him down. Give me your hand.
You okay?
Yeah.
It's not like on TV. Excuse me. Cell 10? Excuse me.
Jimmy.
That man next to you is trying to get his cricket back. It's right in front of your cell.
Jimmy, it's a cockroach.
Sir?
Jimmy, don't lose sight of why we're here.
I know. Douglas Pfeiffer. No innocent man should be in this place.
Ah, this is pointless. The place has obviously gutted.
How was I supposed to know it's out of business? We're here, so let's check it out.
What are you doing there?
We came for some burgers, but obviously the restaurant's closed, so.
I'm calling the police.
Whoa, hold on a minute. We're investigative reporters. This place is the scene of a murder a couple of years ago.
The man who was convicted is on death row. We think he might be innocent.
The hell he is. Pfeiffer, wasn't that his name?
You're familiar with the case?
Oh, yeah. I run the glass shop two doors down. Wally was a sweetheart. I guarantee you he gave that guy Pfeiffer every dollar in the drawer without a peep. Bastard shot him anyway.
Still, how you know it was Pfeiffer?
Because I saw him. Thank God for Wally's silent alarm, because we hear the cops coming and he runs off. But I saw his face as plain as day. Take my word for it. Pfeiffer is absolutely a murderer, and he killed a good man. You guys are barking up the wrong tree.
Here you go, Jiminy. Yeah, take it. Good, Jiminy. Good, Jiminy Cricket. Yeah, here you go. Come on back here and eat this. Come on, eat it up. Eat it up, Jiminy.
Hey. There's a man in here named Douglas Pfeiffer. You know him?
Say, Jack, man, he don't talk.
He don't? He doesn't?
Yeah, I'm a sissy-ass lisp. Sound like a little bitch when he talk. Sound like this. Don't you ever mention it.
Wait. Douglas Pfeiffer. Do you know where he is?
Infirmary. Goon squad called, kicked him good. Patching him up now so they can send him back to the death house.
Armor.
Byers and Jimmy on death row.
It's their idea. Jimmy's, sort of.
Yeah. It's not like we're in love with it.
And here I thought Byers was a smart one. Did it ever occur to any of you to pose as prison guards or attorneys or official visitors from the governor's office?
That's not how they did it on the A-team.
We need you to go in there, Eve, as a visitor.
Oh, please.
We need you to slip something to Byers so we can talk to him.
You go talk to him yourselves.
We tried that. We went in posing as Byers' brothers.
Yeah, and the dumb brother there got caught in the pat-down with this.
I forgot I had it on me. As soon as I said the word firewire, they think it's like explosives or something, the Philistines.
Needless to say, we're on the doo-doo list. Plus, now they're going to keep an eye on anyone coming to see Byers.
But not Jimmy. Plus, you got your, you know, your...
feminine wiles,
yeah.
As it were.
Can't you just fake an injury?
Doctors would know.
Well, then can't you just fall down or kick the bars really hard? Or
if I injure myself, they may just send me for psychological counseling. Jimmy, I'll be the first to admit this isn't the world's smartest plan, but I have to get into that infirmary. Any fight I get myself into, I'll make sure there's a guard nearby who can stop it.
Let me do it instead. No offense, Byers, but you're not the fighting type.
I won't have to be.
Give me your hands. Fall out. Recreate.
He's my bitch, Lowry! Mess with him, you gotta go through me!
Okay. Thanks, Jimmy.
Think it'll snow?
What?
I said, think it'll snow? What's your best guess?
You laughing at me?
Still mad?
I'm gonna mess you up good.
So sensitive. Hey, here's your chance.
Some moron gets himself locked up in here without waiting for him on the outside?
Ah!
Where's John?
Infirmary. You got a visitor.
Hey, baby. You got a kiss for your wife? How you holding up in here?
Oh, you know, can't complain.
I miss you, baby.
Yeah? Oh, yeah. I miss you, too. Because you're my wife and all. I mean, why wouldn't I miss my wife? God, I miss when we make love for, like, hours and hours. And I miss your secret touch. And I miss your, well, of course I miss your...
Cheetos? How about I buy you some Cheetos? Give these to my husband.
So, how are the kids? Little Jimmy Jr. and Peebo. Does Peebo still have that weird thing with his nose?
No, Peebo is well.
Thanks, baby. I like the puffy kind, not the crunchy. But, you know, whatever. Maybe I can trade it for something.
No, honey. You keep those yourself. You keep those, and you think of me.
Hey, what are the chances of us getting a conjugal visit?
Douglas Pfeiffer. I recognize you from your mugshots. The guards really worked you over, huh? Douglas, I'm here at the request of your mother. She says you've been wrongly convicted and yet you're pressing for an execution date. To me, that doesn't make sense. Sounds like you're doing it against your will. I'm an investigative reporter. I want to help you, if you'll let me. Your mother wanted me to know about your request to stop your appeals, about wanting to die. I know you love her very much, Douglas. I know you don't want to go out like this. You'll break her heart.
If you ever say anything about this again, to me or anyone else, I'll cut your throat.
That's a good boy, Jiminy. Good.
to my surprise.
That's Jiminy, huh? I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but if the first one is Jiminy, how is it that that one's Jiminy too?
Maybe it is the same Jiminy. Looks like him to me.
But the first one is dead.
That's if you believe things really die. I don't. I think we just take a trip and come back. Maybe we learn something and move on. Maybe we don't. Old Jiminy, he ain't learn a damn thing. Maybe next time.
Hey, Spike. What are you in for?
Murder.
You contacted Jimmy?
Well, we were just about to do that when we got sidetracked.
Mark my words, if Texas doesn't execute him, I will. What's so interesting?
Mr. Pfeiffer's finances.
26,000 in savings.
And yet he robs a two-bit hamburger joint for 138 bucks in cash. Why bother?
Unless it wasn't a robbery, just meant to look like one.
A contract killing? Who paid for it?
Well, that's where it gets a little tricky. I backtraced the deposits through three separate shells to arrive at one. Brazos Holding.
The same Brazos Holding that now owns the restaurant that Pfeiffer robbed. They've been buying up most of that downtown area, which tells me someone's making an old-fashioned Texas land grab and isn't above killing to do it.
So who is behind Brazos Holding?
Well, drum roll, please.
Jeremy Wash, Pfeiffer's lawyer.
Reading you loud and clear. This thing rocks.
Yeah, yeah. Now, Eve said you told her that Byers got into a fight.
Yeah, but on purpose. Byers had to get into the infirmary where Pfeiffer is so that he could talk to him.
Oh, man. You gotta get word to him, Jimmy. He's barking up the wrong tree.
You two are trying to save the wrong man. Pfeiffer is guilty. No matter what his mother says, he's a killer for hire.
No. No way. Come on.
It's true, Jimmy. And his own lawyer's behind it all.
Mr. Wash?
Yeah, he's got plans for a big high-rise development. A key landowner wouldn't sell, so he paid Pfeiffer to have him murdered.
Wait. So why would Wash want us talking to Pfeiffer?
I'm sure he doesn't, but he's got to go through the motions. He's supposed to be defending his client, right?
I'm sure he never dreamed we'd actually get you guys in there.
Now, here's the thing, man. Pfeiffer may not be innocent, but there's a guy in there who is
a prisoner by the name of Wallace Crendel Atherton.
Yeah?
We think Walsh framed Atherton for the murder of another shopkeeper who wouldn't sell. A mechanic by the name of Michael Keeley.
But Atherton is innocent.
Which cell's he in?
Tolan! Your shadow's in my house. Get your shadow out of my house.
Shut the hell up, Atherton. Go play with your bugs.
Thanks. Wallace Crendel Atherton.
Fella. I'm healing up good. Tomorrow they'll put me on death watch, and 36 hours after that.
It doesn't have to be that way, Mr. Pfeiffer. My friends and I want to help you.
Why?
Like I said before, your mother told us all about you.
Yeah. I'd do anything for my mom. You're right about that.
Mr. Pfeiffer, about the murder you were convicted of.
I still got nothing to say.
This Atherton guy was at the wrong place at the wrong time, that's for sure. And Wash destroyed any piece of evidence that might prove his innocence. We got squat that'll save him.
Byers has to get a confession out of Pfeiffer. It's the only way.
That's Eve.
What I want to know, what does Wash have over Pfeiffer that Pfeiffer won't rat him out? Well, Mr. Wash. Langley, Wash is here.
Have you learned anything?
Learned anything? No.
Nada. Oh. Sorry.
Where are your two friends?
He's out getting his beard trimmed. The one with the beard, and then the other one is helping him.
Aren't you going to get that?
What? Well, the door. Yeah, sure. Why not?
You know how you owed me before? Now you really, really owe me. I'm taking these clothes off and burning them.
Hi. Jeremy Wash. Sorry to interrupt. You were saying? They owe you?
Oh, I owe her. She's agreed to marry me. I mean, can you believe it?
Huh. Wow. No.
Yeah, we're going to Vegas tonight. Give us a kiss, sweet cheeks.
Of course, Toad Boy.
Well, happy nuptials. I just wanted you to know that Doug's execution is going forward day after tomorrow. I have to break the news to Mrs. Pfeiffer, unless you can offer us any hope. Thanks for your efforts.
Yeah, you bet.
Toad Boy.
Sweet cheeks.
So what'd you get?
I convinced this lonely credit union manager to let me peruse through his Stone Age, non-computerized files. Wash has been making deposits to Mrs. Pfeiffer's account ever since her son's conviction. Mm.
Explains why Pfeiffer won't talk.
Yeah, he gets the death penalty whether he rats out Wash or not.
Wash can help his mother or harm her. If Pfeiffer goes quietly, she'll be taken care of.
But meanwhile, this Atherton guy...
Yeah, an innocent man. He's gonna die.
We can't let this happen. We gotta get the poop on this lawyer Wash.
The key is Pfeiffer. Jimmy's got to get a message to Byers.
His name is John. He's in the infirmary. You'll get it to him?
Yeah, sure. You sure you can trust him?
I gotta trust people. Until they prove to me I can't. Spike?
Mm-hmm.
What if somebody knew you were innocent? Because you are innocent, right?
You, me, and God know it.
Right. Let's say this somebody and his friends find a way to prove it and get you out.
That ain't gonna happen.
But what would you do? I mean, if you were a free man.
Well, sir. First, I would shake the hands of the men that set me free and thank them with all my heart. And never again would I squander a moment of precious time on earth that God has given us. And I would devote myself to realizing my lifelong dream.
What's that dream?
caring for those that can't care for themselves. To end the mistreatment of the most mistreated of all God's creatures.
You mean the poor?
I mean cockroaches.
Cockroaches?
So, talk.
Pfeiffer's being transferred to Death Watch tomorrow morning.
So?
You're gonna make sure he never gets there.
Well?
Nothing. Gave the guy the note like 6 hours ago.
What guy?
The trustee. He promised he'd give it to Byers.
Oh, yeah, like that's gonna work. Well, we got less than 8 hours before Pfeiffer gets transferred out of there.
8 hours, and we'll never talk to him again.
I'm sorry, guys. What are we gonna do?
We're gonna save your butt. Later.
So how am I looking there, Doc? Healthy enough to kill?
Please, Mr. Pfeiffer. You're running out of time. They're about to transfer you out of here.
Prisoner. Got any smokes?
No.
Take it anyway.
Pfeiffer, it's time to go. Put your lights on.
You did it.
Yeah, I did it. Not who my mom thinks I am.
No. But you could still be. Tell the truth. Tell the truth before it's too late.
Pfeiffer out of here.
Wesley, you're coming with me.
Inmate 999-0962.
Yeah, I think so.
Hands? There was a problem with your transfer order. I think you and I both know what it was.
Open number 7.
Step out.
The Sergeant Runzelhoff. That man is innocent. He's not a murderer.
Go on.
He didn't do it.
Don't make me leave without my friends.
Son, this isn't a place for you. You should have spoken up a long time ago. Officers, sign for the prison.
What'd you tell him?
Computers told him, not us.
You're sent to the wrong prison. You're a peeping Tom, not a killer.
Peeping Tom? What about Byers?
Right here, Jimmy.
Pfeiffer?
Let's go home, boys.
Sergeant, I've been waiting 40 minutes, and I feel like you people are giving me the runaround. Did something happen to my client?
Yes, sir. An inmate attacked him in the infirmary.
Oh, God. He's not.
Dead? Oh, no, sir. He's fine.
Good. So the transfer is going to proceed.
Your client's not being transferred anywhere. Not yet.
What are you talking about? Doug.
You're fired.
Mr. Pfeiffer just implicated you in the murders of Wally Spinella and Michael Culey.
Sent Larry after me? Couldn't wait another 36 hours for me to die. Son of a bitch.
There's a couple of gentlemen here who are going to want to talk to you. Rangers? As of 12:01 a.m., Douglas Robert Pfeiffer is dead. Mrs. Pfeiffer. Figure it's like Spike and his cockroaches.
Jimmy,
maybe we don't so much die as learn something and then move on.
This.